Hey guys, it's Raquel Reads and I'm back with another video. So today I am going to talk about a specific book, and it's called Wild Bird by Wendelin Van Draanan, and it's one of the first books that I read for this year's book Battle of the Books. And we've got four books that have to do with Battle of the Books. This is the first one that I read and it's really good, which means that I'm gonna have more book talk videos coming in the near future. So basically, what is this book about? So this book is about a girl and her name is Ren. She's a very troubled kid. She's kind of going through a lot of tough things, and this is kind of in a it's not really dystopian. At first I thought it was, but it's not. I thought it was kind of like the books Unwind, where you can kind of like get rid of your kid, but it's not really like that. But instead of Unwind, it's more of like a rehab center. And so her parents, they think she's troubled, they think she needs help, so they send her to this camp in the middle of the desert where she kind of learns about herself, learns about friendship, learns about taking responsibility for not only her actions but her feelings and her emotions. It's a really good book, and I kind of finished it feeling really refreshed. Really, like, it's a feel-good book, you know? If you have not read this book yet, I would advise you to leave if you don't want to be spoiled, because we're really gonna get into this book. We're gonna talk about the characters, the setting, the way that this book is written. So if you don't want to get spoiled, please leave this video now, and once you read it, feel free to come back and we can talk about it. So now that everyone who has not read the book has left, or maybe they're still here and they don't mind being spoiled, we can really get into Wild Bird. Now, at first I was kind of skeptical about reading it, mainly because the whole setting of the book is a camp in the middle of the desert, and if you know me, I am not the camping type. I mean, I want to go camping. It sounds fun. It sounds like I would genuinely like it. Here's the thing, I don't want to go to the bathroom in a hole in the ground, and that's mainly one of the biggest reasons why I don't want to go, plus the bugs. But I really, if we could just take out the bugs and the fact that I have to go to the bathroom in the ground, I'd be great. I'd be great going camping. I would have no problem with it. So that's why I was a little skeptical about going into this book, because I was like, I don't know if I'm really gonna get into it, because it's all about camping, it's all about survival instincts, and you know, and I'm the type of person who likes to read stories about like fantasy and magic and princes and princesses, and you know, in a love story, and this is just not that. But it's still really good, and I was also a little skeptical about going into the book because this book is written more like a middle school type of book. Like, you would, like, this book is more of like a book that you would read maybe like 4th, 5th, 6th grade, maybe 7th grade. It's not a very young adult book. I mean, the simplicity of it is so middle school, like, you know, like, I read this book like so fast, like I just zoomed right through it, but it's so easy. But you know, nevertheless, I loved it. I fell in love with Ren and all of the characters. It was beautifully written, so good. So I mean, after I finished the book, I wanted to go camping. So if that doesn't say anything about how good this book is, I don't know what does. Now, the first character is Ren Clemens. She's the main character. We first learn about her in the beginning is when she's woken up at like 3 in the morning or like midnight. It's really late. Her parents are sending her off to this like soldier, like police type of person. And she has no idea what's going on. All she knows is that she wants to leave and her parents gave her up. And that's all we know. That's all we know too. And that's why at first when I started reading this book, I was like, is this dystopian? I was like, is this like a weird, like, like book kind of like unwind, where like your parents like kind of give you up or whatever. And so I was really confused. I was like, what is going on? But no, this book is actually very modern, kind of, I mean, it doesn't really talk much about like the outside world, like our world today. There's really no mention of a phone or like TV or a computer at all. I mean, especially because they're at this camp in the middle of the desert. That's what we learn about Ren in the beginning. She's kind of a survivalist, and she's got these instincts. So she's sitting in this car with this soldier type police person, and she knows that all she needs to do is escape. I mean, if it were me, if my parents gave me up and made me go to a camp in the middle of the desert, I would have been so angry. I would have been like kicking and screaming. I would have been like, get me out of here. But she's so calm, she's so collected, and I think that's one of the reasons why she's such a great survivalist, is because she's thinking through everything that she needs to do to get out of a situation that may be dangerous. Well, anyways, Ren Clemens, when we read through the book, we read about her flashbacks. There's flashbacks in the book, which I really love. I mean, you read about what's going on in the present, what she's going on in the campsite, and then she kind of has these flashbacks, these memories of her friends, her family, kind of her early childhood years. And this is where we get to learn more about Ren, because usually in the present, Ren is kind of standoffish. We don't get to learn much about her in the present, but we do get to learn a lot about her in the past. And so this is kind of where we learn that she's kind of a troubled kid. She didn't get along with other kids. She didn't get along with her sister or her mom, or even her dad. She was kind of closed off from her family. She missed her family. We just learn all of these things about her, and then we kind of develop this. Well, Ren, we read more about her. She kind of strips away this shell that she has around her feelings. She's learning more about herself, which is what we realize in the flashbacks. She's having these flashbacks because she's learning about herself, because she's taking responsibility of her actions, because she wants to become better. And it's such a great way to get to know a character. I mean, at first I was a little like, why are we constantly going back in the past? But then when I finished the book and I really reminisced in the book, I was like, that was such a good way for me to get to know Ren. I loved Ren after reading it. She's really just this character, and she's younger too. I mean, she's in her middle school, like early high school years, and she's already got like this very smart head on her shoulders. She knows what she's talking about. She knows what she wants. She knows that she can change and that she wants to change. And we really get to see that in Ren, and I love that. She's such a great character. She's such a great role model, I think, because she wants to, and even when she changes, even when she realizes that she wants to change and that she wants to become a better person, she doesn't back down from the people who have kind of beat her down. And this includes her family, because she never got along with her family. Her family was kind of treated her more like a stranger than a daughter. And she's just always fighting the fight and surviving. And I feel like that's such a great way to get a character across, to fall in love with a character. She's such a good character. I love her so much. Such a good role model. I think all girls should read this book, especially because Ren is so lovable. We get to know so much about her. She's just an all-around great character. And then we get to read about Annabella Clemens. Annabella is her older sister, I think. Yeah, her older sister. And they do not get along. I mean, Annabelle is like constantly snitching on Ren, and Ren is constantly accusing Annabelle, even though Ren knows very much well that she's the one who did all of these things. And then as they got older, you know, Annabella became this goody two-shoes, never got in trouble, was always telling the truth, was always honest. And then Ren became this troubled kid who smoked weed, who had bad influences as friends, who wasn't telling the truth, who would steal, who would lie. Of course, that sounds like Ren is a bad character, but of course during the book she changes. But that's how Annabella and Ren were. And in the ending of the book, I really, I cannot tell you how much I loved the ending of the book. Annabella, we learn about Annabella through Ren's memories, through Ren's flashbacks. And so when we read the book, at first we're like, Annabella is the worst. I hate her. Like, why is she so annoying? You know, like all of these really negative thoughts about Annabella. But at the ending, when Ren is about to leave her rehab, the camp, they always have a family member who comes and camps with them at the campsite to kind of ease them into the old life that they had. This family, Ren's family, they go to visit her before they leave for their home, you know? And we meet Annabella face to face for the very first time. Not through Ren's memories, but in the present, like in the now. And Annabella is kind of like, you can see the snottiness, the attitude of Annabella that we've always learned through Ren's flashbacks. But then we also see that Annabella truly loves Ren. And especially when Ren discovers that she truly loves her family and that she misses her family and she embraces her family when they come to visit. And Annabella, we see she's in awe of Ren. She's like, you look like a warrior. You've changed so much. I'm so proud of you. And that, like, honestly, I'm gonna start crying just thinking about it. But that is such a great way to introduce a character, especially from flashback to present. Because at first we're like, Annabella's horrible. And then we meet Annabella, and then we realize that the sisterly love is more than just getting into arguments all the time and snitching on each other all the time. And I really loved that. I really loved reading about Annabella. And this also goes along with the mother too. Ren had trouble connecting with her mother and loving her mother even. She listens to Ren. She talks to Ren like Ren is a normal person. Like Ren is her daughter. And normally when we read about Ren's flashbacks, we see that her mother is kind of impatient. When she asks a question, she doesn't wait for Ren to answer. She continues to ask more questions. She continues to lecture her, to give her a spiel. And we don't see that in the ending of the book. We see that her mother has changed. Now, we don't know specifically sure if Ren's mother has actually changed, because like Annabelle, we've only ever heard about her mother through Ren's memories. But we do see that Ren, more specifically, sees that her family has changed in her eyes. And I think that's really special to think about and really cool and creative. And then we've also got small characters, and my favorite small characters, supporting characters, were Michelle and Hannah. And Michelle, it was the soldier, the leader of the group. She kind of taught these kids, these girls, how to change and who to be, how to take responsibility for their actions. She taught them skills, survival skills, and all those types of things. She's just super cool. And I really liked her. I really wanted to know more about her. I liked that even as an adult, she's spending time with these girls, you know? Like, she wants to get to know more about them. She actually cares for them. And Hannah's the girl who did heroin before she came to the camp. And she has a hard time not relapsing, and she's really afraid that she's going to relapse once she leaves the camp. And her and Ren become very best friends while they're at the camp, because they kind of talk about each other's pasts. They get to know each other. They get to figure each other out and help each other through these tough times while they're at the camp, while they're doing their whole rehabilitation, you know? The book was very well written. I mean, I loved it. At first, I thought it was gonna be more like middle school, like it was gonna be too easy to even get into, but this was really good. I mean, it was very easy to read. It was kind of like a middle school book, but it was really easy to get into. It was really easy to fall in love with the characters, and I absolutely loved it. The book, there were some sentences in the book that I was just like, this is a really good sentence. But yeah, really well written, loved it. Now, I have a favorite quote, and I used it on my Bookstagram when sharing about the book. And I don't remember what page it's on. I probably should have written that down, but I'm an idiot. I think it's sort of near the ending. I have it here on my computer, and it says, I want to be someone who remembers the stars, even in daylight. I want to be someone who looks up. And I really love that quote. I don't know what it is about that quote, but it's just, it's so good, and I really want to remember it, and I really hope that you guys write that down somewhere too, because it's such a good quote. It really resonates with me. All around, this book was really good. I really recommend it. I mean, at first I was a little scared to even go in it. I mean, I started reading this with very low expectations, but now I absolutely love it. I think it has to be one of my new favorite books. It's really good. You should definitely pick it up. 5 out of 5. I mean, if I could give this any more stars than 5, I would. But Goodreads kind of wants to limit me, so that's okay. But yeah, this is definitely a 5 out of 5, 10 out of 10. Great book. Definitely pick it up, especially if you're on the younger side. I definitely think you would really like this book. There isn't really any like love story to it. There is this really cute boy that Ren finds cute, but there's really no love story. I mean, I really think the biggest love story, which sounds so cliche, this is gonna sound so cheesy, but like I think the biggest love story in this book is between her and, well, herself and nature. And I think that's really special because a lot of books don't have that. A lot of books sometimes aren't very successful if there isn't like a romantic scene or like a romantic couple. And this book really succeeds its expectations. I really loved it. Definitely go pick it up. It's really good. All right, well, that is the end of my video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like or dislike it. If you didn't like it that much, that is okay. Comment anything down below, what you want me to read, what you want me to watch. I will definitely make a video about that. And subscribe to my channel if you want to journey with me through my TBR list, because I have plenty of books that I still need to read. And I think that is that. All my social media links will be down below. And yeah. All right, bye guys.